We're going to keep working on riddles and puzzles, word problems. And let's look at this particular problem. The sum of two numbers is 15. One less than three times the smaller is equal to the larger. Find the numbers. Actually, there's a few ways you could do this one problem, so that's just what we're going to do. We're going to solve this in more than one way, but just using one variable. One method is, since the sum of the two numbers is 15, remember, and we're looking for a smaller and a larger, is we could just define one of the numbers as n, and since the two numbers add up to 15, remember what the other number is going to be? 15 minus n. Okay, just a quick note, remember it's because n plus something has got to be 15. So if you're going to solve for what's in the circle, you're going to have to subtract m from both sides. And that's how we know that that other number is 15 minus n. You could also verify if you add n plus 15 minus n. Yeah, it does add up to 15. Those are our two numbers. So what it says is one less than three times the smaller. So basically it's saying if you're taking away one from three times the smaller number, because it doesn't look like an m, that's going to give us whatever that larger number is, right? So this is sort of like halfway between words and algebra. Now let's plug in what we called the small number. We called the smaller number n. And then the large number we called 15 minus n. And so there's one way of getting the equation if this is how we defined our small and large number. All right, so now we can solve this. Let's add n to both sides. Remember, that's the same thing as 1n. And let's, since the variables are going to be on the left, let's also add 1 to both sides so we have the constants on the right. So 4n is 16. That'll be pretty easy to simplify. Divide both sides by 4. So n is 4. So it looks like our numbers we're looking for up here are 4. And what's the other number? 15 minus 4 would be 11. So let's see if this makes sense. The sum of the numbers is 15. Certainly, 4 and 11 add up to 15. Also, if I do 1 less than 3 times the smaller, well, what's 3 times the smaller number? 3 times the smaller number, well, 3 times 4 is 12. And I'm going to do 1 less than that. That gives me the bigger number. Yes, so that all checks out. So it looks like the numbers or 4 and 11. All right, that's one way to solve this problem. Now we're going to do it again using a different method. This first time I solved it, I let the small number be n. Okay, let's do it a different way. This time let's let the large number be n. Then what would the small number be if the sum is 15? Well, again, we'll have to do 15 minus n so that these two numbers add up to 15. And let's see, it says one less than three times the smaller. So again, it said three times the small number, one less than that, right? One less than three times the smaller number is the same thing as the large number. But this time we're going to plug in, what are we plugging in for the small number? 15 minus n. Make sure you use your parentheses. And that's going to equal to the large number, which is n. So notice you get a really different equation than the first way I did it. See how I have 3 times 15 minus n? The first way I did it, I had 3n minus 1 equals 15 minus n. That's because I defined my small and my large number differently. All right, so let's finish this one. We do the distributive property. We have 45 minus 3n minus 1 equals n. And that gives you 44 minus 3n equals n. And I'm going to add 3n to both sides. So I have 44 equals 4n. And almost done here. If I divide by 4, I get 11 equals n, or you could write n equals 11. And so, going back up here, if, remember I got n equals 11, that means my large number is 11, and my smaller number is 4. I get exactly the same answer as I did the first time, but the two numbers are 4 and 11. The small number is 4, the larger number is 11. Depending on how where you put your n, your equation might be different, but remember, it's a word problem. When you go back up, your final answer will end up coming out correctly as long as you followed what was said in the words and translated correctly. So I still got 4 and 11. All right. Now, I'm going to do this one more way. Take the same problem. Okay, here it is again. The sum of two numbers is 15. One less than 3 times the smaller is equal to the larger. You could have actually defined both of these a little bit differently, since the larger one is one less than 3 times the smaller. How about if I just let the smaller one be n? Then the larger one is one less than 3 times the smaller, right? So what you could have done is taken the second sentence to define your variables and now use the first sentence, the sum of the two numbers is 15, to get your equation. It's actually easier in this particular problem if you thought of that. So I'm going to take the smaller number plus the larger number is 15. So the smaller one's n, the larger number is 3n minus 1, and I have 4n minus 1 is 15. We're going to add 1 to both sides to get 4n equals 16. Divide both sides by 4. Oh, check it out. There again, we got 4 for the smaller number. And if the smaller number is 4, we said the larger number is 3 times 4 minus 1, so that's 12 minus 1 or 11. And so we keep getting that the two numbers are 4 and 11. So three different ways to solve the same problem. And the check is the same. You make sure that they really add up to 15 and that one of them is that the one less than 3 times the smaller actually equals a larger number, which is absolutely true. So it doesn't matter which way you solve it, but it does matter how you define your variables and how you write your equation. You have to do that one of these ways to end up with the correct solution, which is right here. The numbers are 4 and 11. In the end, that's what matters, that you get the right numbers and that your definitions for your small and large number make sense, and that your equation comes from how you define your smaller and your larger number based on the words originally. Okay, I know that's a lot. And of course, you don't have to do it three ways. You only have to do it one way. I just showed three ways to show you that there's always usually, how do I want to say that? Almost always, there's more than one way to figure out a riddle, to solve a puzzle, to write an equation, etc. So be creative. All right, the sum of two numbers is 2. The difference between 8 and twice the smaller number is 2 less than 4 times the larger number. Find the two numbers. All right, we're looking for two numbers, a smaller and a large one, and the sum of the numbers is 2. So how about one of them is n? And then the other one then will have to be 2 minus n so that they add up to 2. All right, next part. We're going to look at the second sentence to figure out how to write the equation. It's a difference. It's the difference, or subtract, between 8. All right, so the difference has two parts here. It's between 8 and twice the smaller number. All right, so we've got 8. And twice the smaller number then would be 2n. That's the difference between 8 and twice the smaller number is, means equal. All right, 2 less than 4 times the larger number. So I'm going to take away 2, right, from something. From what? 4 times the larger number. So 4 times what we said the larger number, which was 2 minus n. So there's the equation. All right. Put the video on pause and solve it. All right, here are the steps in solving it. First, I did the distributive property, the 4 times 2 minus n. Then I combined like terms on the right-hand side. And then I got the variables on the left, constants on the right, by adding negative 8 plus 4n to both sides. And last step was divide both sides by 2. So for n, I got negative 1. So we go up here, n is negative 1. And then the larger number is 2 minus negative 1. Remember, that means 2 minus a negative 1, which is 3. So the numbers are negative 1 and 3. To check it, you have to go back up to the top and see if negative 1 and 3 make sense. I'm going to leave that to you. Make sure that the difference between 8 and twice the smaller is really 2 less than 4 times the larger.